Hi, Craig here from Craig Rogers Photography. Now, if you're like me and have multiple Lightroom catalogues, you might have come across this problem where you want to open up an old photo in Lightroom, but you can't remember what catalogue it's in, or it's not in the catalogue you thought it was in, and you're like, oh, I can't find it anywhere. It's pretty difficult because you have to open up a catalogue in Lightroom, not in that one, close it down, open up another catalogue, no, it's not in that one, and so on and so on. It takes forever. So it's rare for me to have this because I'm quite organised with my catalogues. But this morning, a customer ordered this Misty Sunrise shoot that I did about 3 years ago. They wanted a print of it. So I opened up my Sunrise catalogue in Lightroom, but this shoot wasn't in there. And I thought, okay, there's got to be an easy way to be able to search for this photograph through all of my Lightroom catalogues. And I came up with an idea that I can use in PowerShell. So before we begin, make sure you back up your data, make your Lightroom catalog data. You should be doing this anyway. And even though we're not going to change or modify any of your catalogs by doing this very simple process, it's always a good idea to back up your data just in case something goes wrong. If you haven't already seen the video, click on the top there. I have a way that I've been doing this for many years where I have a log-off script. Every time I shut down my PC, all my Lightroom catalogs get copied over to my NAS. Which is a great way of automatically backing them up, so you haven't got to worry about doing them in Lightroom. So check out that video. But anyway, back up your Lightroom catalogs before we go messing around. So a Lightroom catalog is actually just a SQL database that Lightroom uses. And when I had a look inside one of the catalogs, I noticed that the file names of the photographs are stored there in plain text. And I thought, this is great. If I can work out how I can search through all of my Lightroom catalogs in one go for a file name, I should be able to find which catalog this photo belongs in. Okay, so the first thing I did, I looked up the photo name. So here's the actual photo stored on my NAS, and there's the raw file of the shoot. And here we go. So that's the raw file of the shoot. And its file name is _dsc5721.nef. Okay, I use the standard naming convention on Nikon cameras. So I thought, brilliant. I can use that file name, do a search through all my catalog files, and I should be able to find it out. So what I did, I used a thing called PowerShell, which is a very powerful tool in Windows. So to run PowerShell, the easiest way to get it open, click the start, the search bar, type in PowerShell, open up a PowerShell. Now it's very similar to the command prompt or the old MS-DOS, and many of those commands work in here as well, but it just goes that one step further and it's quite powerful. So the first thing you need to do is change to the folder that your Lightroom catalogs are stored in. Now for me, as you will see on here, I have a D drive, which is an SSD, and my Lightroom catalogs are all stored in a folder called Lightroom catalogs. Okay, and then obviously Lightroom creates its own folders for the catalogs. So for me, I need to go to the D drive, D colon, and then CD. In PowerShell, if the folder name has a space, you have to put it in single quotes. So Lightroom catalogs, quote. And if I do a simple DIR command here, you'll see that the list that is given is the same list you see in Explorer. Okay, so I'm now in the same area where all my Lightroom catalog files are stored. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to use a command in PowerShell called getChildItem. So here's a command I use. I'm going to copy that and I'm going to paste it in. And then I'll sort of quickly tell you what it does. You don't need to know what it does, but basically getChildItem is basically a command for you to issue to PowerShell for it to go away and bring back a list of files depending on the criteria you give it. So what the criteria is here is go and get a list of files. If the file has got star.lrcat in it, okay, which is the catalog file, and inside that file has a string which is the name of the photo, okay, the file name of the photo, list it. That's pretty much what this command is doing. If you want to know, the minus recurse, minus depth, one, that basically means go down into a subfolder but only to one level, so it's not going to have to go and search through all of the preview data that's also in the catalog folders. But basically, that's the command. Now, if you're watching this on the blog, this command is on the blog, so you can get it from there. If you're watching directly on YouTube, look in the YouTube description, and you'll be able to cut and paste the command from in there as well. Save you typing it in. So all I've got to do is run that command, and now it's just going to go and search through all my LRCAT files to find that file name. How long will it take depends on the speed of your machine, the speed of your hard disk. Of course, I've got SSD, so it'll be quick. And, of course, how many catalogue files you got and how big those catalogue files are. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to cancel that because here's one I prepared earlier. So I run this command earlier on, and when it finished, it gave me two options, okay? So it gave me a LateGuarder 2012, or it gave me a São Marcos de Serra. LateGuarder 2012, it's not going to be in there, wouldn't have thought. That's a very old catalogue from when I went to Italy on an older camera. This is why it's in there, because obviously I use the standard convention, and they've got two photographs with the same name. However, São Marcos de Serra is a catalogue I started using many years ago, and then I didn't actually continue using that one. So it looks like I probably put that photograph in that catalogue. So if I now go to Lightroom and open that catalogue, which is here, because I opened it earlier. Open it up. It's going to take a while, because all these photos will be on the NAS, so it's a little slower to launch. Okay, so, and over here, there it is. Missed 16th of April, 2018. If I click on that once it does, and look at that. There we go. I have found that photo inside the catalogue. Okay, so it's a very, very simple way of tracking down where a photograph, or what catalogue a photograph belongs in. It's a very, very quick and easy way to do it. So hope that helped you if you're struggling to find a photograph. Subscribe me for further videos, and I'll see you all soon. Bye for now.